signs of low self-esteem are you won't even go out of the house if you're not done up. You know, you got to always make sure you look good, or you never know who you're going to see, or blah, blah, blah. We're conditioned at a young age to act and look a certain way so that people think differently or people accept us. So we're taught from a very early age that we're not good enough. What's up, hot moms? Hey, going over self-esteem today. I know I'm Casey. Welcome to the group. If you're new, I look like Fido's ass most days because I work from home. And you know what, though? I'm going to get my hair done today. My lashes done. It is what it is. Got some trash bags in the car here. Full on mom in a six-figure sports car. You know, that's what hot mom is all about. All right. A lot of women struggles with self-esteem. It's why we struggle with anything, ultimately, because if we fully believed in ourselves, we fully had just like all the self-esteem, we fully trusted that what we wanted and what we wanted could come true, and we weren't even scared to want something because it's a no-brainer. So self-esteem really stems from, obviously, the way we're brought up. A lot of times your mom, your grandma, this is a mother wound, by the way. I mean, father wounds can creep in certain areas, okay? But for the most part, mother wounds are some of the big reasons why we have these invisible blots when it comes to self-esteem. And so often I talk to women that they're scared to dream. They're scared to want more until they get in my energy, of course. Just like yesterday, I had one gal and she's a stay-at-home mom and she does have a side hustle. And she goes, you know, I just don't want to work. I want to be X, Y, and Z. I don't want a lot of pressure on me. I don't want responsibility. I'm like, wait a minute. You have three kids and have your hands full and you don't want responsibility or pressure? That's not true. Let's go deeper. And she's like, wow. She messaged me over and over like, I loved our call yesterday. Because most strategy calls, that's what we get into. So she gets in, she enrolled, and she watches my video that I did yesterday for my private girls. And I went over a story about my son and a video game and about money and stuff like that. And she goes, you know what? You nailed it. She goes, I want to be able to provide for my children and not feel like everything costs so much money or I can't provide. If my kids want to go to Disney and they want shirts or my kids want shoes, I want to be able to get it for them. And I went over the thing because I know, like, I grew up where, hell, them little things got to learn what money is now. They don't need every damn thing that they ask for. You know, I know how some of y'all think because I used to think that way too. And that's a very wounded way to think. That's not like you have to go in and completely redo the way you think. That way of thinking just like breeds other negative ways of thinking because of the limiting beliefs that we have about money. So I teach you all that because unlocking what it is that's causing you not to have self-esteem, not have the body, not have the health, also will unlock why you have these fucked up beliefs around money. So self-esteem, it's the mother wound, right? And a lot of people think, well, my mom was good and all that, and I get it. That's why I say invisible, because a lot of people, they don't even see this. So signs of low self-esteem are you won't even go out of the house if you're not done up. You know, you got to always make sure you look good, or you never know who you're going to see, or blah, blah, blah. We're conditioned at a young age to act and look a certain way so that people think differently or people accept us. So we're taught from a very early age that we're not good enough. We have to wear makeup. And now look, I'm the first one bimbo over here. I love big titties. I love plastic surgery. I love Botox. I love fake hair. I mean, I want to look like a porn star. We are conditioned at a very early age that we're not good enough. And then we watch our moms struggle with their wrinkles, their body, their exercising because they ate wine last night. You know, we watch our moms and our women and our family just, they're not truly happy. They're always trying to people please. They don't want to fuck up. They're trying to be a really good mom. They're trying to go without to give us stuff. And then they resent that. And then they want to know why they're so fucking tired and they're pissed off and they yell at us and stuff like that, right? So all these little things build up over time. And then media comes in, and then we have friends that make us feel unworthy. Now that's a female wound, because when you truly know that you're the shit, like you're good, it's not that somebody else is something's going to take away from you. You know, if you're jealous and insecure of your man cheating on you, if you're jealous or insecure that somebody's going to like them better than you, that's a feminine wound right there that literally... Every day you're making decisions based out of fear of not being good enough, and that's causing other negative things to happen because you're deeply insecure about it. So the best way to build self-esteem, A, take care of yourself. And I understand that self-love is not something that's taught in school. Actually, when I used to see self-love, like quotes or just how to love yourself or girls posting self-love, it would gross me out. It would gross me out. I would be like, oh God, these fucking happy bitches and acting all happy. They're fake as fuck. Now, some of them are because they're trying to convince themselves that they're happy and they're really not. But for the most part, I just hated myself. I fucking hated myself. I hated pictures of myself. I was never good enough. Everything that I did, it could be a better job. Like, there was always this inner critic of, yeah, but it could be worse. You know, Casey, you're struggling with this. Fucking, there's people out there that don't have any food. It could be worse. You know, you don't matter. So, I mean, we could go all day on this, but little things that you can do for your self-esteem. Set a goal. I've got this in my free gifts. If you go to caseyship.com/free gifts in my jumpstart guide, I go over like how to set goals. But I also have in there a video bank. Like, y'all, it's about 20 videos of some badass shit. That's the energy in it is transformative. You have to swim in that energy. Because another way to increase your self-esteem and self-worth is to be around other women that actually give a fuck about themselves, that actually do see their worth, and it gives you permission. Like, when you see other women winning and being confident, and they do have self-esteem, true self-esteem, not fake self-esteem, gives you permission to do the same. So that's one way to do it. Setting small goals. Look, it could be making the bed. Anything small that builds your self-esteem. What's something exciting that I could look forward to? And then at the end of the day, journaling, like, what's something good that happened in the last 24 hours? What are two things that I got done today? I actually made my appointment. I went to get my hair done. I went to walk outside. I ate a banana today versus Starbucks sugar coffee. It has to feel good. All we're doing energetically all day is shifting how we feel into something that feels a little bit better. Working out, you know, for me, I hated myself so bad. Like, oh my God, I hated myself. You know, when you reach a certain point of success, that old self kind of creeps in and causes you to feel like you need to be doing something else. You're not working hard enough. And that's old. That's old programming. It's not needed anymore, you know? So sometimes that may happen. You just have to really be aware of that voice. Step in and give yourself the nurturing, like that motherly fairy godmother nurturing that says who you are is of very high service. And, you know, good things are happening to you and better things can happen. Keep going. You got this. You know, any little thing that just feels good. You got 20 pounds to lose. Fuck it, right? Once you start feeling like you're good enough now, the 20 pounds goes away. Another thing that you can do is ask yourself, all right, if I already had the thing that I wanted, if I already had the money, if I already had the man, if I already had the body, if I already had the legs, if I already had the ass, if I had the energy, if I had the thyroid numbers, if I had the health, how would I show up today? And you show up like that, okay? If you had the time, if you had extra time, because you do, just say it. Just start believing. I have a lot of extra time. I have so much fucking time. Time is on my side. What needs to get done, get done. I have so much fucking time. But if you had a lot of extra time, what would you do today? What would you do? If you didn't have to do the thing you didn't want to do, what would you be doing instead? Okay, make that happen. Like little small things, because it's totally possible. The only thing that's stopping you is like your mindset. That's it. And we go really deep. Look, we go into the psychology, the science, the woo-woo. We go into everything really, really deep with strategy and Hot Mom. So if you're listening to this and you're wanting a lot more and you're wanting the how, you're just going to have to book a call and fill out an application on the caseyship.com/book-a-call so that we can see what's going on and actually come up with a plan for you. Also, deciding, just you being in here, it's done, it's over. Just decide today, hey, you know what? I have the vision in my head, I know what I want, I've got the goal, I'm already there. All I've gotta do is align with that goal. Think of money, you know, like lottery winners, right? And why they lose all the money is because they're not an energetic vibrational match, an energetic match for that money. They still feel, they're still that poor person deep inside. They're gonna lose their money. It's like people that get gastric bypass. And that's why when girls reach out and say, hey, I just had stomach surgery, give me a workout, I'm like, whoa, bitch, no, we don't do things like that, because you're still that fat girl. You're still that girl that eats her emotions. You're still that girl that hates herself. You're still that girl that was abused and ridiculed and beaten down emotionally as a child. You're still that girl. We have to go and work with her, and then everything else works out. Let's just decide that you're already the things that you're wanting, the body, the health, the The certainty, the confidence, the fact that you want it means you can have it, but wanting it pushes it away. You know, chasing the cat, the cat's going to run away from you. Wanting it and being in that white knuckle and like wanting it and just like beating the pavement and thinking you got to like work out so hard and restrict so hard and just get on this different diet. Wrong. You have to go inward. It's about input. It is the output. You guys are trying to paint your house and you don't even have the foundation set up. That's like what a diet and a fucking workout does. You have to go inward. You have to address, you have to do personal growth. You have to go inside and heal your shit. The reason things aren't working out is because of what's inside. It's because you have low self-esteem. Because guess what? Everybody around you growing up had fucking low self-esteem. That's it. So, like I said, let's start back with decide. Come up with a goal. Come up with a small goal. Something you can feel, energetically get behind. A small goal that feels really good. It feels like the opposite of what you're feeling right now. Certainty. It feels so fucking certain. Like, I just know it. I just know it. It's like when you went to school and you got your degree. It's like when you were pregnant and you knew your baby was going to come out, or maybe you didn't. It's like when you went to do whatever it is, pick out your car, pick out your house, pick out your wedding ring, pick out your, I don't know what you did, but I know you women can decide. Hello, we're women. I know you can. And if you can't, that's a wound too. We can clear that up. Let's just pretend like you can decide. Pretend like you can decide and you can't fuck it up because you always make the right decision. So just go ahead and decide on the goal that you set is going to happen. Commit to the end result. Commit to the outcome. And everything in the middle, trust. You trust because you've asked, you've done the work, you've put the energetic, right? You've done the energetic work. Now it's your turn to go, all right, now you get inward and you get in that flow of taking the first step to feeling better. Okay, well, what can I do today that feels better, that feels like the person that I want to be? It's moving today. I want to go walk today. You know what? I'm going to go walk. I'm going to say no. I'm going to ask my husband for help. I'm going to get a sitter this weekend so I can fucking get sexy as hell and go out. Whatever this makes you feel better, that will boost your self-esteem more than anything. Also, do you hate your fucking flab? Do you hate your midsection? Do you not like your legs? Do you feel like if you could just have Casey's legs, you would be like, couldn't tell you shit? Okay. Do what Casey does. Do what Casey does. Casey does lots of inner work, soul work, right? I'm always daily. I'm so committed to how do I feel? How do I want to feel? What's in between there? What are some fucked up stories that I'm telling myself? How can I rewrite those? Got it. And I'm always just trying to stay in that vibration of what it is that I want. And I observe those funky feelings if I'm off, and I just observe and go, okay, so I'm feeling off here. Let's see what that's about. And I do the work and I show up, I take the practical steps. But that's because I love myself. And you know why? Because I do exactly what I just told you. I set the small goal, which was I want to be a fitness model. Okay. I believe that I could do it eventually. I took the practical steps in between. I ate a certain way. I did the certain thing because I trusted that's what I was going to get. I'm not stopping till I get that. Because if I get that, I feel like I can do anything. And in that process, I became more confident. And confidence comes from clarity and certainty. When you can get clear on what you want, certainty comes in because certainty feels good. Certainty feels like, fuck yeah, definitely. It doesn't feel like, well, I mean, I don't know if I'll have any more money coming in. Like, this is a lot, or that I don't have a lot of time for that. If I do this, it's going to take away from that. Fuck no, that's fear. That's fear, fear, fear. That's what's keeping you in this fucking perpetual shit cycle. You have to go back. What does your future self say? What does the bitch say that does have self-esteem and that's not going to take no shit and that's going to figure a way out of getting out of survival mode so that she has like unlimited vitality from the video games? What does she do? And you do that. Like, listen to something, turn on something that makes you feel so badass and stay in that vibration. Stay in that vibration when something comes up, address it like, what is that? Feels funny. Okay, let me go back to this. Do that over and over and over. Write down, celebrate your wins, even if it is bleaching your teeth, even if it is watching my video, making the appointment. The thing that you admire in me, you have too. Otherwise, you wouldn't recognize it. It's going to take a little time to get the physical. Be okay with that. That's my one-on-one on self-esteem. The reason you're not where you want to be is because you don't have self-esteem. Same with me. The next level that I'm trying to get to is belief, self-worth and belief and self-esteem. I have to constantly get my mind and challenge myself and address these things with the steps that I give you in Hot Moms. I have a 9-step process of exactly how to do this. So you've already got it in you. Decide, go back through this, break it down and do the work. Got it? All right, y'all kick ass. I'm looking forward to hearing about your breakthroughs. And if you want to work with me, if you want to know, like if you just want more and you want somebody to go, dude, yeah, you want to pull out what it is that you really want and like do it and make it happen, I got you. Just book a call. We'll get you in. It's time. I got you. Let's book a call. KaseyShipp.com/book a call. And we will talk. We'll go over and see what's going on. You know, maybe you need a mini course. Maybe you need Hot Moms. You know, we don't know. So that's what the calls are for. So looking forward to meeting you.